Let's start. Hello, I'm Thomy Gölles. I'm working for a company called Solvion in Graz in Austria, and I'm an Office Dev MVP, and you can reach me at my Twitter handle. Today, we want to talk about the Microsoft Graph Toolkit in Blazor and in Teams. It's a little bit different than what Victor just showed us in terms of we used, or in my demo, we're going to use the Blazor components instead of React. So no EO teams. It's a different way of working. Don't get me started in between what is better or what is the better way to go. It always depends. I know it's a consultant saying, but it's a different tool and you might have reasons for that approach or for this approach. I will go in some details why I think in some cases Blazor is the way to go, especially if you think of all the releases that will come with .NET 6 later in November this year, with finally the vision of one .NET coming through, and all the platforms, all the clients will be served by one .NET version. And of course, Blazor is part of that. The Graph Toolkit, we will use specifically for that target audience. I myself have a 10 years SharePoint background. So of course, we are using the Graph Toolkit in a lot of our solutions. Might not be the way that a classic .NET developer that starts out and says, okay, Blazor is an option for me to surface something in Teams goes, but I think this audience might have some experience with the Graph Toolkit, and it's a quick way to start and have authentication running in Blazor and Teams, and that's what we're going to see in a couple of minutes. First, Blazor, it's the cool kit if you think of everything WebAssembly. WebAssembly basically means that the server is sending down a bunch of DLLs to your client on your phone, on your browser, doesn't matter, because every modern browser has some sort of a mono framework running, being able to interpret that and surface then HTML in the browser. Major difference, client-side, server-side. Server-side really runs on a backend, connecting to the browser with SignalR and back and forth. That's we're going to show today, and we're going to focus on today. Here, the first big difference is if you think about authentication, client-side really lives in the browser. So it's not a smart idea to store any secrets in a client-side Blazor solution. There are ways to go into the code, to disassemble the things, and then you basically give away authentication. That's why a server-side might be more interesting, or ways how you can connect the client to a server to handle authentication in a proper way. And I think I have a line in there, and I'm just saying it out for reasons. I might lock somewhere a token to make sure that I can grab it. Never do that in production. I've seen that too many times. Never lock any bearer tokens on production servers. If you want to know more about Blazor, that's the one URL you need to know. It's a big list of all possible tutorials, training materials. If you start reading this today, you might not finish until the next community call. So there's really a lot of information in there. But enough with PowerPoint. Let's go directly into the code. And I'm opening up here a prepared Visual Studio solution that's actually already running here in our small demo. And what we see is the basic Blazor application that you get with next server-side solution in Visual Studio. Small introduction, a login component from the Microsoft Graph Toolkit, and an agenda component inside my application here in my browser. And of course, prepared already also in Teams, sideloaded with a custom app and a static tab here. So same site. How are we handling authentication in this solution? Let's go to the code. And the auth part basically is done by providers from the Microsoft Graph Toolkit. How can we make use of the Microsoft Graph Toolkit in Blazor in a server-side solution? We have a file hosts.cshtml. That's where you just link your script files. So I'm linking Microsoft Teams SDK, and I'm linking the Microsoft Graph Toolkit loader. Also, we will need this later. I will link a custom startup JavaScript file. We will see how we use that in a couple of minutes. This is how everything is loaded. And then in my index eraser file, I'm just popping in a Microsoft Teams provider, and a Microsoft Teams, Microsoft Graph Toolkit Teams provider, and the Microsoft Graph Toolkit MSAR provider. Why both? Because my application is running for once standalone in the browser, and also as a Teams application. And either way, I'm opening the application, the providers here know what to use. And you see, these are different IDs. So these are two different Azure Active Directory applications connected to the providers, just to show you how you can even go this way. That's okay for Teams. I'm going with that application in my AD. For the normal way as a normal standalone application, I'm using a different approach, because if you think of all the different .NET applications that are out there and existing, might be a good idea to surface some of the information in this application in Teams. Not the whole solution, not the whole navigation part, just important parts of it. And then you can reuse your existing code, because with Blazor, you can take your existing C-sharp backend code, move over, let's say, from an ASP.NET Forms application. There are the link that I showed you before. There's even a project that moves over existing Forms applications to Blazor, and you can reuse existing logic in C-sharp directly in Blazor. That's one of the reasons why I think that with all the huge amounts of still .NET Forms applications out there, there's a big, big opportunity for Blazor in the future. Next to our authentication providers, the demo is really simple. We just use the Microsoft Graph Toolkit agenda component to surface a schedule from myself from a certain date, so that we can make sure, okay, we have some data in there. I don't think I have something for today. That's why I'm going back to an old date in here. But let's see the difference if we comment out some of those providers here. For example, let's comment out the MSAR provider and restart the application. So we are now saying, okay, I'm only once authenticate through Teams. This is again my normal application. No sign in working. So no way to sign in, because of course we said we commented out the MSAR provider. We are relying only on the Teams provider. Let's move over to Teams. We need to reload the application because I'm just surfacing a local host here. Click on sign in, going through an off page, and I'm in here. And this short off page is actually configured in this off pop-up URL. And I have this page here. All it does is it just says, okay, Microsoft Graph Toolkit Teams provider, handle authentication. And that's all Teams needs to wire the user through to the authentication, and we're good to go. And there is one big difference. If you think of this application now being a tab, just sideloaded in my Teams environment, compared to taking the same application and just put it in as a tab, as a website. I'm going in there now and just flash my local storage. There is basically where all the tokens are stored, and refresh that page. And you will see that inside just a tab that is a website, there is no way to sign in. I can only sign in my sideloaded application, because this is the only way the Teams SDK gets called and does the magic with the Microsoft Graph Toolkit. The other way around, if I go back now, it will be here. Why? Easy answer. It's the same application in the local storage, is local host. And you see here, this is my MSAR keys, and this is the application GUID from my Active Directory application. And you see how basically the tokens are stored. They are all stored in the local storage. That's why it's easy that's why it's possible that you can now log in this page if you first click here. So that's a little bit confusing. Just think of it. The Teams SDK only gets served really if you do a proper application, not just by putting in a tab in a Teams in some places. Next thing is, and the last thing for today, we have now our login. Let's comment that in again to make sure it just works. And go to a second demo that does a little bit stuff a little bit different. We stop duplication and restart, because now we want to reuse the token that we get from the Microsoft Graph Toolkit. Application will fire up in a few seconds. There we are. I'm still connected because, of course, there's a caching here. I click on Get Teams. It calls now out to the Microsoft Graph Toolkit to get the token, and we will see all my teams that I'm part of in this dropdown. And if I go to the correct one, there should now be a next call and get back to the Microsoft Graph and display all the users from my selected team with their email addresses and their roles. So how did we end up here? Very easy. This is the HTML code for the button, for the dropdown, and for this member table. And what we need to do is, and that's the interesting part, we're calling in Blazor JavaScript code. And the JavaScript code we call is get token. And remember, I told you we have a startup JavaScript file that's here. And all we do is we say get token. And then we just use one line of JavaScript. Microsoft Graph Toolkit providers, global providers, get access token, getting the access token back. And then we call our own custom graph service. And the custom graph service then uses the .NET client from Graph in a special way with the delegate authentication provider, because I already have a token. So I start this with the token, and then it's a simple call, graph service client, get my joint teams. And it's a little bit special because the second one to get the members actually use the beta endpoint. And to get the beta endpoint working together with the G8 one, you need to trick your project files a little bit, because you need to create an alias, because both files actually use the same namespace. That's a little bit tricky, but if you create an alias, you can use actually the GA version of the graph client and the beta version in the same part. And of course, one call get teams is the G8 version, and the second one is the easier call to just get the beta endpoint and get back all the users, the email addresses, and the roles. And that's it. I'm 1 minute short, Vesa, 13 minutes.
Excellent. Marcin, I can see your hand up, but unfortunately, there's so many people in the call that we're running out of time. If possible, can you ask that in the chat for Thomy to follow up on that? But Thomy, thank you. Thank you. Awesome stuff. Absolutely brilliant stuff. And great, great, great demo. And this, Mikael Berglund had a pretty recently cool demo related on Blazor as well. So there's more and more focus on the Blazor. It's really, really, really cool stuff. And I think there's so many people who are coming from this kind of a classic C# server-side background. So this is more natural way of doing development. Or what's your take on this, Thomy? Is it for you natural, more natural than
for me? It's more natural because I can't write React code that way. I'm more proficient with .NET. Never jumped over that wagon. So, it depends. It's no right and wrong in my world.
Absolutely. But cool. Thank you, Thomy, on that one.